He's not more wounded than Here's the fruit for you, Bill.
Thank you.
Now, Bill, if I can't see, I can hear a finger stirring. Business is business. Hold out your left hand. Now that's done.
Doctor, I
an emerald, we'll take my man murderer. We'll have money to eat, so roll a number out.
Troy, I'll go with you.
I will too!
There's only one man I'm afraid of.
And who's that? Name the dog, sir.
You cannot hold your tongue. These fellows who attack the incident and war are all bound they'll get that money. Not one of us must breathe a word of what we found.
I will be as silent as a grave. Hello, Jim. Bravo! The ship's company complete. The ship has been launched and fitted. The Hispaniola. Everyone in Bristol proved helpful as soon as they got word of the port we sailed for. Treasure, I mean.
What about Dr. Lucy, sir? You were just out to talk about it.
Who's a better writer? The squire can't talk. Pretty wrong, though.
It's A. I have trouble finding the right crew for this voyage. To luck brought me the bag man that I required. I found an old sailor. He knows all the seafaring men in Bristol, and I need a good berth as cook to get to sea.
Why he want to go to sea when he's got a nice place on land? Why, the squire hasn't asked you never would have got me away from his estate. What the land will look like by the time we get back, I can only imagine.
You give up a treasure hunt for a garden?
Yes, Red Ruth. Sure the rose bushes will be fine without us. Long John Silver, the cook is called, and he's lost a leg in his country service. Between Silver and myself, we got together a company of the toughest old salts imaginable, and now we are all ready for our treasure.
When do we sail?
Sail? We sail tomorrow. You may come aboard if you run this note to John Silver. That is it. The spy glass.
Mr. Silver, sir.
Yes, my lad. Such is my name. And who may you be? Oh, I see. You are a new cabin boy. Pleased I am to see you.
It's Black Dog! Stop him!
I don't care two coppers who he is. Though he hasn't paid his score. Morgan, run and catch him. Now, what did you say his name was? Black what?
Dog, sir. Has Mr. Tolman told you about the pirates? Well, he was one of them.
So, in my house, one of those swabs, was he? Step up here, Morgan. You never clapped your eyes on that black dog before, did you now?
Not I, sir.
And you didn't know his name?
No, sir.
By the powers, Tom Morgan, it's as good for you. And what was he saying to you?
I don't rightly know, sir.
Do you call that a head on your shoulders? Come now, what was he saying? Voyages? Captains? Ships? Pipe up, what was it?
We was a-talking of keel-hauling.
Keel-hauling, was you? And a mighty suitable thing, too. Get back to your place for a lover, Tom. See now, Hawkins. Here's a hard thing on a man like me, ain't it? Here I let him give us all the slip.
It's not your fault, Mr. Silver. How could you chase him down with your leg?
This won't do. Duty is duty. I will step with you to Squire Trelawney and report this here affair.
You need to come along. I can tell them well enough myself.
No. Can't be done, Master Hawkins. I can't allow the name of my establishment to be mixed up with the likes of that black dog. We'll say how I kicked the lover out as soon as we caught on to his game. Tell the right men your stories, lad, and half your battles are won. You've been through a few battles yourself already, have you?
Yes, I've had to escape from Black Dog, and I was hoping the lesson was kind on our voyage.
You can never be sure of who you'll meet on these here adventures, Jim. Just keep a weather eye open and stick to your friends, and you'll come out all right. Right then, lead the way, Master Hawkins, and we'll be there and gone before you know it.
You can call me Jim, Mr. Silver.
Long John to his friends, Jim. Long John to his friends.
Seaworthy?
Well, sir, let us speak plain. Even as a
Possibly, sir. You don't like your employer either.
Stay a bit. Nobody asks such questions as that. The captain has said too much, or he has said too little. And I am bound to say that I require an explanation of his words. You say you don't like this cruise. Now, why?
I was engaged, sir, on what we call sealed orders. To sail this ship for that gentleman where he should bid me. So far, so good. Now I find that every man before the mast knows more than I do. Do you call that fair? I don't.
No, I don't.
Next, I hear that we are going after treasure. I don't like treasure voyages. I above all don't like them when they are a secret. And when, begging your pardon, sir, the secret's been told to the parrot.
Silversmith.
It's a matter of speaking. Lad, I mean. It's my belief that you, neither of you gentlemen know what you are about. But I'll give you my opinion. We'll be risking our lives on this trip.
That's all true enough, most likely. We take the risk. But we are not so ignorant as you believe us. Next, you say you don't like the crew. Are they not good seamen?
I don't like them, sir. And I think that I should have had the choosing of my own hands.
My friend should perhaps take you with him. But this slight, if it was one, was unintentional. And you don't like your first mate, Mr. Arrow?
I don't, sir. He's too free with men. A mate should keep to himself. Shouldn't be drinking with the men before the mast.
Do you mean he drinks?
Oh, he certainly does have an answer. Though he'll be hard-pressed to find the liquor on my ship.
Now then, the long and short of it, tell us what you want.
Well, gentlemen, are you determined to go on this cruise?
Like I.
Very good. Then hear me another word. Why not put the powder and arms in the cabin and put your own people in the berths here beside you?
Any more?
Just this. There's been too much blabbing already.
Far too much.
I'll tell you what I've heard from about every man except the cook. I've heard that you have a map of an island, and that on this map there are crosses to tell where the treasure lies, and the latitude and the longitude of the island.
I never told that to a soul.
Perhaps know it, sir. I don't know who has this map, but it should be kept a secret, even from me and Mr. Arrow. Otherwise, I should ask you to let me resign.
I see. You wish us to keep this map in the dock and to make a garrison of the stern part of the ship. In other words, you fear mutiny.
Sir, I deny your right to put words into my mouth. No captain would be justified in going to sea if he had grounds enough to say that. Some of the men are honest, all may be. But I'm responsible for the safety of this ship and the lives of every man aboard her. When I came in here, I meant to be discharged. I hadn't the thought that Mr. Trelawney would hear a word.
No, I wouldn't. That lives enough in here. As it is, I have heard you, and I will lose you desire. But I think you're worse than you.
That's as you please, sir. You'll find I do my duty. You there, ship's boy. Off with you to the cook and get some work. I'll have no favorites on my ship.
Contrary to all my notions, I do believe you've managed to get two honest men on board with you. That man and John Silver. I don't put much faith in your discoveries, but after his nearness in capturing Black Dog, I will say that Silver suits me.
Silver, if you like. But as for that intolerable humbug, I declare I find his conduct unmanly, unsailorly, and downright unengaged.
I agree with you.
But you look here. You're young, you are, but you're as smart as paint. I see that when I set my eyes on you.
You're the first one on this trip to say that.
Oh, aye, but I won't be the last. Mark my words. You're one who was born to shine one way or another. Come away, Jim. Come and have a yarn with Long John. Nobody more welcome than yourself. Sit you down and hear the news. And we'll peel some potatoes while we're at it. Well, it's all for the good, ain't it?
Well, I was hoping you'd be fighting the pirates. Or at least sweep the decks by now. But I could do the potatoes.
Here's Captain Flint. I called my parrot Captain Flint after the famous buccaneer. Here's Captain Flint predicting success on our voyage. Was he, Captain?
Trouble of putting him in irons? Mr. Ann? I don't like this cruise. Not one bit.
Doctor, I have terrible news. Give the captain and squire.
on your duty. Mr. Trelawney and I and Dr. Livesey are going below to the cabin to drink your health. And you'll drink our health. If you approve, give a good sea cheer for Trelawney, who suggested it.
Huzzah!
They left us alone with Clay. It's like they're giving us the amulet and the silver platter.
Aye, lad. Never trust the silver platter.
Well, Captain, you were right. That was wrong. I await your orders.
No more wrong than I, sir. Never heard of a crew that meant a mutiny, but showed signs before. This crew beats me.
Captain, with your permission, that Silver, a very remarkable man.
He looked remarkably well for a yardarm, sir. Now, we must go on because we can't turn back. If I were to give a word to go about, they would rise at once. What I propose is we come to blows one fine day, when they least expect it. We can count on Redruth, Mr. Trelawney.
As upon myself.
Well, with us, with ourselves, that makes five. Counting Hawkins.
To think that they're all Englishmen, I can find it in my heart to blow the ship up.
Well, gentlemen, we must keep a bright lookout to discover when they plan to strike.
Jim here can help us more than anyone. The men are not shy about him, and he's a very noticing lad.
Well, we must use whatever men we have left to us. Hawkins, I expect your best work.
Hawkins, I would probably say.
Thank you. I'll do my best.
If I could take one more order on this cursed ship.
Lower the gigs to go ashore, men.
Well, it's not forever.
Aye, aye, sir. Cheer up, men. It's a fine hot day and we've reached our destination.
Come with me to the cabin, please, Dr. Livesey. Sir, if I risk one more order, the whole ship will come down about our ears. Now, we only have one man to rely on.
And who's that?
Silver, sir. He's as anxious as you and I to smother things up and keep those men working. And I suggest we give him that chance. Why not give the men an afternoon ashore? Silver will bring them back again. Mild as lambs.
Capital idea. We'll prepare as you deliver the news.
My lads, it's been a hot day, and we're all tired and out of sorts. A turn ashore will hurt nobody. The boats are still in the water, and I'll fire a gun a half an hour before sundown.
Huzzah!
All aboard for coming ashore, mates!
Hans, you stay aboard. You too, Gray and O'Brien. What, Jim? You don't want to be staying here with your doctor and his pals?
No, I'd rather be with you and the crew. Don't you want more help?
All right, then. Good to have you along, lad.
Well, Redruth, what do you see? How are our chances?
There's three of them once left on board.
Three isn't bad at all. Should we attempt a fight?
Pardon me, sirs, but Jim Hawkins has gone ashore also.
What? He's not safe with those men. What was he thinking?
Probably a young boy trying to do the best work for his friends.
Well, that makes a mess of our plans. What do you men think of taking the stockade on the island? It looks from the map that it's not too far from shore, but it's far enough that the men on the ship would not be an immediate threat.
If it means fresh water, mine for it.
If we can't take the ship, I say we get away from this blasted crew.
Good. Redruth, get below me ready.
Aye, aye, Captain.
That came from shore. Let's hope it wasn't the end of Hawkins. But that man Gray, he nearly fainted when he heard the shot. Another touch and he'd join us.
You really think after joining us Silver that
with a brace of pistols each, so you needn't try anything. Mr. Trelawney, go help Redwood bring up the supplies. We'll pack the boat and be gone in no time.
Now, Captain, what's all this?
You know very well what this is, my man. So you just stay where you are, that's a good fellow.
Oh, understand half of what you said, but you have something to propose, and you wish to see Dr. Squire aboard the ship again. Now, you wait here, now may I go?
I reckon you can, Jim. And Jim, if you was to see Silver, you wouldn't go for to sell up and go? My horses would go for me? No? It's okay?
It's a pity, sir, we weren't able to bring back another load of supplies. As for powder and shot, we'll do. But rations are short. Very short. Oh, blaze away! You've little enough powder as it is, my lads.
Sir, the house is quite invisible from the ship. It must be the flag or anything. Would it be wiser to take it down?
Strike my colors! No, neither I, sir.
Sir, someone's hailing us.
Doctor, Squire, hello! Redruth, is that you?
Help the lad over the wall, Redruth.
Jim, we thought you were done for. I thought I was too, but I've met someone.
You can tell us while we work. Now that all hands are accounted for, we can make the stockade presentable. Mr. Gray will need to get a firewood. Mr. Trelawney, take stock of the supplies. Redruth, you can continue to keep watch.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Dr. Livesey, would you take up position as cook?
Of course, Captain.
And Jim, you can help the doctor make dinner. Get to work, men.
Flag of truce. It's Silver himself.
Stay back, men. 10-1, this is a trick. Who goes? Stand and fire!
Flag of truce!
What do you want with your flag of truce?
Captain Silver, sir. Come aboard and make terms.
Captain Silver? Who's he? I don't know him.
Me, sir. These poor lads have chosen me captain after your desertion, sir. We're willing to come to terms. All I ask is your word to let me safe and sound out of this here stockade, and 1 minute to get out of shot before a gun is fired.
I have no desire to talk to you, my man. If you want to talk to me, you may come. If there's any treachery, it'll be on your side, and the Lord help you.
That's enough, Captain. A word from you's enough.
You had better sit down.
You aren't going to let me inside the lockhouse, Captain.
Why, Silver, if it had pleased you to be an honest man, you might be sitting in your galley.
Well, well, Captain, you'll have to give me a hand up again. There you are, Jim. There you all are. Together, like a happy family in the manner of speaking.
If you have something to say, my man, better say it.
Well, here it is. We want that treasure, and we'll have it. You would just as soon save your own lives. What I mean is, we want your chart. Now, I never meant you no harm myself.
That won't do with me, sir. I know exactly what you meant to do. I don't care. For you see now, you can't do it.
If Abe Gray...
I passed there. Abe Gray told of me nothing, and I asked him nothing.
Well now, that may be, but here it is. You give us the chart to get the treasure by. You do that, and we'll offer you a choice. Either you come aboard once the treasure is shipped, and I'll give you my word of honor to clap you somewhere safe ashore. Or, if that ain't to your fancy, you can stay here.
Is that all?
Every last word. Refuse that, and you've seen the last of me but musket balls.
Get to your posts! Gray, I'll put your name in the log. You stood by your duty like a seaman. Mr. Trelawney, I'm surprised at you.
Apologies, Captain.
My lads, before the hour is out, we will be boarded.
We trust your leadership, Captain.
Who's the best shot?
Mr. Trelawney, out and away.
Mr. Trelawney, you and Gray take the long north side. That's where the danger is. Dr. Livesey, you'll take the south side. And Redruth and I will take the east. Jim, you'll stand by to load it.
I can't help the fit.
You'll help, as I said. I want everyone to their posts, please.
Pardon me, sir. If I see someone, I want to shoot.
I told you so.
Aye, aye, sir.
Huzzah! Adam, all hands, all hands!
Be right in a couple of turns. And where might you have come? This here's an unlucky ship, this Hispaniola, Jim. There was this here O'Brien. Now he's dead, ain't he? Now I'm no scholar. Your lads can read and put things straight. What do you suppose? Is a dead man dead for good? Or do we come alive again?
You can kill the body, Miss Higgins, but not the spirit. You should already know that.
Well, that's unfortunate. Here's the killing persons was a waste of time. Now, fetch me an apple out of the barrel, lad. Likely be my last. For my long hope, no mistake.
The apple barrel is empty, and if I was you and thought of myself so badly, I would go to my prayers like a Christian man.
Why? Now, tell me, why?
You were just asking me about the dead. You've broken your trust and lived in sin and lies. Here's a man you killed lying at your feet, and you ask me why? For God's mercy, that's why, Mr. Hands.
Never seen good come of goodness yet. Them as strikes first is my fancy. Dead men don't bite, them's my views. We're near the bit now. You just stand by and take my orders. We'll sail in and be done with it.
You're right, Mr. Hands. There's a north inlay now.
All right, take a starboard a little. Starboard. Good, good. Now, my hearty, bluff!
Well then, here goes.
Avast! Who are you, George Mary?
thought you was captain here, perhaps. But by the powers, I'll teach you better.
George is right.
I stood being lorded over by Smollett long enough. I'd be hanged if I'd be lorded over by you, John Silver.
Did any of you gentlemen want to have it out? With me? So that's your sworn, is it? Perhaps you can understand King George's English. I'm captain here by election. I'm captain here because I'm the best man by a long sea mile. You won't fight, as gentlemen of fortune should, then by thunder, you'll obey.
I won't stand for you playing favorites, John.
You're right. I like that boy. He's more a man than any pair of rats of you in this here house. And what I say is this. Let me see him that will lay a hand on him. That's what I say. You seem to have a lot to say. Pipe up and let me hear it, or lay to.
I ask your pardon, sir, but this crew is dissatisfied. This crew has its rights like other crews. I'll make so plain as that. And I take it we can talk together. I ask your pardon, sir, but I claim my right. Steps out for a consul. According to rules,
fetch the council.
Excuse us, Long John.
Now you look here, Jim. You're within half a plank of death. They're going to throw me off. But I stand by you through thick and thin. I didn't mean to. No. Not until you spoke up. But I seen you was the right sort. I says to myself, you stand by Hawkins, John, and Hawkins will stand by you.
You mean all's lost?
Aye. When I looked out into the bay and see no sooner, well, I'm tough. But I gave out. I'll save your life so be as I can. But you look here, Jim, tit for tat. You save Long John from swinging.
I'll do what I can.
It's a bargain. You speak up, Plucky, and by thunder, I have a chance. I'm on Squire's side now. I know you've got that ship somewhere safe. How you've done it, I don't know.
It is safe. Here they come.
Then let them come, lad. Let them come. I've still a shot in my locker.
Well, Silver, we've come to a decision.
Step up, lad. I know the rules I do. I won't hurt a deputation. The black spot. I thought so. Where might you have got the paper? Why, hello. Look here. This ain't lucky. You've got to cut this out of a Bible. What fools cut a Bible?
Why, what did I say? Now I've got to come on that, I said.
Well, you've about fixed it now, among you. What lover had a Bible?
It was Dan.
Dan, was it? Well, Dan can get to prayers. He's seen his last slice of luck, you may lay to that.
But end that talk, John Silver. This crew is to do the black spot in full council. You just turn it over and see what's wrote there. Then you can talk.
Thank you, George. Well, what is it? Ah, deposed. That's it, is it? Your hand, George. You'll be captain next, I shouldn't wonder.
Come now, you don't pull the screw no more.
I thought you said you know the rules. I'm still the captain until you out with your grievances and I reply.
First, you made a hash of this cruise. Second, you led the enemy out of this here trap for nothing. Why did they want out? I don't know, but it's pretty plain that they wanted it. And then third, there's this here boy.
Is that all?
Enough, too. Well, I'll swing for your bungling.
Well, now, look here. I'll answer these 3 points. I made a hash of this cruise, did I? Who forced my hand, as was the lawful captain? Why, it was you, lovers, that's for number one.
Go on, John. Speak up to the others.
And if you want to know about number 3, and that boy, well, are we going to waste the hostage?
here, Captain. I'm done with it.
Silver!
Silver forever.
Long John for Captain.
So that's your tune, is it? George, lucky for you as I'm not a revengeful man. Now back to bed and it's treasure in the morning.
Jim, we've had quite the voyage, you and I.
from that cabin boy to look at you now. All of my nerve and none of my black heart. Almost a pity.
Almost a pity? You can't stay and try to remake yourself? Will you go to your wife, or is there no one you can trust in this world?
Precious few, Jim. Precious few. Her and one who stands on this deck. I says to myself, you stand by Hawkins, John, and Hawkins will stand by you. I forgot many men I haven't given a farthing for, but you, lad, I'll never forget. Farewell.